Catholic Church, we celebrate the Sacred Heart of Jesus. The Sacred Heart reminds us all that the doorway to the life and the love of God Himself comes through the pierced heart of Jesus. And one of the important things that this image reminds us is the purpose and the role of each of our human hearts. And one of the biggest, most important journeys any human person makes is from their head to their heart. So when they learn to rest in their heart, they can hear the presence of God knocking on the doors of their own heart, as the Sacred Heart of Jesus reminds us through its open wound. Here at the Montfort Academy, the school has tried to provide not just an academic foundation, but a moral foundation for its graduates to make that journey from their heads to their hearts as they witness not just the goodness, not just the truthfulness, but the beauty of God in the world that they will be commissioned through this graduation ceremony to go into. With that thought in our minds, my brothers and sisters, let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we ask that the Holy Spirit be upon these graduates, that their hearts may become open with the power of your love as they seek to grow in a deeper knowledge and understanding and wisdom of your presence that is freely given to them, not because of anything they've done, but because of who each one of them are, your beloved child. We ask your blessing to also be on their parents, their primary educators and teachers in this life that you have entrusted to your children here this day. And finally, for your blessing, your joy, and your peace to be upon the faculty, staff, and administrators here at the Montfort Academy as they seek to encourage and cultivate a sense of joy and of wisdom for generations to come. We ask all these things through your most holy and sacred name. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
We recognize the following students for achieving the status of graduate cum laude for a cumulative grade point average of 3.0 or better: Miguel Benedetti and Brandon DePanfilo. We recognize the following students for achieving the status of graduate magna cum laude for a cumulative grade point average of 3.67 or better: Natalie Lambrelli and Andrea Pineda. We recognize the following students for achieving the status of graduate summa cum laude for a cumulative grade point average of 4.0 or better: Olivia Blair, Sharon Bustamante, Catherine DiPropersio, Katrina Estrella, Leonardo Generoso, Mary Greco, Mary Ellen Kelly, Ashley Mahane, Gabriella Palomino, Nicole Scalisi, and Naya Cionarini. The New York State Comptroller's Award recognizes students who have shown consistent academic excellence and potential for leadership through involvement in activities that improve the school or their communities. This year's New York State Comptroller's Award is presented to two students, Olivia Blair and Andrea Pineda. Thank you. New York State Attorney General's Character, Courage, and Commitment Award recognizes students excelling in academic pursuits, participating in community service, displaying leadership among their classmates, or overcoming personal challenges. This year's New York State Attorney General's Triple C Award is also given to two students. The first could not be here today because she is very sick, and we certainly miss her. Sharon Bustamante. Is given to Mary Ellen Kelly. The Congressman Elliot Engel Leadership Award, our local Congressman Elliot Engel sponsors an award in his name, which recognizes one student from the graduating class who has displayed exceptional leadership ability. For his singularly distinctive accomplishment of earning the rank of Eagle Scout in the Boy Scouts of America, this year's Congressman Elliot Engel Leadership Award is given to Brandon DeCantlo. The New York State Academic Excellence Award recognizes overall outstanding contributions by students to the academic and social environment of the school. This award is accompanied by a scholarship that is given directly to the College of Attendance by the student. This year's New York State Academic Excellence Award is presented to three individuals. They are Natalie Lambrelli, Ashley Lehane, and Nicole Scalise. We will now commence with the traditional Montfort Academy Awards, those selected by faculty, coaches, and administrators of the school. The Senior Athletic Award is given to the male and female athletes who have demonstrated sustained excellence in their athletic endeavors, to include skill, competition, effort, commitment, sportsmanship, and leadership. For her commitment to personal and team improvement, and for her quiet leadership, positive attitude, and constant encouragement of her teammates, the Montfort Academy Senior Female Athletic Award goes to Ashley Lehane. include great performance, caliber of courses, self-challenges, and contributions to the learning environment. For sustaining an average of 4.39 during her time at the Montfort Academy, and for 4 years of overall academic excellence, and for her academic leadership example and thoughtful contributions to classroom discussions, the Montfort Academy's Senior Academic Award goes to Catherine DiPercursio.
Give the folder right after. All right. This year, we had the pleasure of hosting a student from Buenos Aires, Argentina, as an exchange student, Ms. Maya Madison. From the moment I interviewed Maya through Skype from her home in Buenos Aires, I knew that she would fit in at Montfort. Born into a family of both Jewish and Catholic heritage in Buenos Aires, Maya was interested in coming to America to study and to learn more about her Catholic side. Because Argentina is in the southern hemisphere and school begins in January instead of September, Maya was part junior but mostly senior this year. All of Montfort embraced her immediately, and she embraced Montfort immediately, and we will dearly miss her. We'll miss her smile, we'll miss her happy demeanor, her curiosity, and so much more. Maya, please be sure to give our warmest greetings to your parents, and please know that you can count Montfort as your home and these 25 graduates as your friends. So I would ask that you please come forward and be recognized.
Graduation candidates, please rise for the conferring of your degrees. Secretary Greco, as Vice President of the Montfort Academy, I nominate for board approval these 25 candidates for award of a high school diploma. I testify that they have well and faithfully completed the course of study approved by the Board of Trustees and consistent with the Board of Regents of the State University of New York, as documented by these letters and certified by the seal of our pen.
Thank you, Colonel Chua. On behalf of the trustees of the Montfort Academy, I, Richard Greco, Chairman of the Board of Trustees, offer greetings to all those with whom these words shall reach. Let it be known that these 25 students have well and faithfully completed the course of studies approved by us in testimony of the self-same through these letters certified by the seal of our academy. We, through the authority granted by the Board of Trustees, undersign our names, given in Mount Vernon on June 8th, in the year of our Lord, 2018.
Antonio Stefan Alfaro. Antonio will be attending the John Jay College of Criminal Justice in New York. Miguel Angelo Benedetti Neto. Teresa Cleary Burke. in West Haven, Connecticut.
Natalie will be attending Manchester. Before she returns to Baltimore, Ms. Topkins will lead our annual summer service trip to Honduras, along with Mr. Miller. Let us keep Ms. Tompkins, as well as Mrs. Tompkins, in our prayers, and let us now show Ms. Tompkins our gratitude for her service to the Montfort Academy. For our concluding prayer and benediction, the Montfort Academy Campus Minister, Mr. Matthew Turley. For those of you who do not know me, my name is Matthew Turley, and I have the distinguished honor of being the Campus Minister here at the Montfort Academy. If you've heard about some crazy guy who runs around in sandals, that'd be me. Well, I can't believe it's over. Oh, your time here, not the ceremony. We have another 2 hours of this. Sad thing is, they think I'm joking. 3 years ago, when I first met you, my time with you as a campus minister and spoke to you publicly as a class, I told you a story. And so since this is my last time addressing you as a class, I thought it was appropriate to end my time with you the same way that I started, by telling you a story. Once upon a time, there was a forest in which there lived many wondrous creatures, and in particular, a group of young birds. These birds had been gathered into this particular forest in order to be taught how to survive in the outside world around them. When looking at these birds, there didn't seem to be anything special or wondrous about them. And they began to compare themselves to other creatures in the forest. They thought that they were looked down upon because they did not seem to possess any special qualities or talents. After a year, a new teacher was brought to them, whose job it was to teach and impress upon them a single important lesson, something that they would always need to remember if they were to survive. The lesson, as it was often referred to, taught them how they could be like the first one, the one whose image and likeness they were created in, although they were not able to see nor understand this. The lesson was that, unlike the other creatures in the forest, they possessed the light of the first one within them, and that light had to be focused, to be the focus of their lives, if they were to remain in this realm. Finally, after 3 years, the time came for the young birds to live the lesson. They were told to focus on the light of the first one and to hold it deep within them. And as they did this, the great transformation took place. Each of them was set ablaze into their true form, that of the great phoenix. And with the light and fire of the first one now living within them, they were ready to go out and light the way for the rest of the realm. But an enemy had surfaced, one who could destroy the light and the ways of the first one, and to do so developed a technology which could destroy them and the fire that burned within. This weapon was so insidious that not only would it extinguish the light, but it would reduce them to ashes as well. The enemy used the weapon on them, and as they fell, the words of their teacher came back to them, that as long as they focused on the light of the first one, they would always be a part of the realm. And so although they fell, seemingly extinguished in ashes, but because the lesson had been so ingrained in them, it reignited the fire of the first one within them, so that they were always able to rise from the ashes, reborn to continue to fight the good fight. This is a unique time for me, because you are the first graduating class that I have actually taught in the classroom, and we have been through much together. I've shared your joys and sorrows. I've laughed with you. I've laughed at you. And I've even cried with you. And together we have helped each other carry our burdens. But like the birds in our story, when I first started to teach you, you held yourselves in little esteem and thought that others viewed you the same way. Not so. I have always seen in you the potential for greatness, and that someday you would light the world on fire. You are all unique because of what you do, and I can summarize that attribute with a single word: love. First, you care for one another. When one of you is down or hurt, you rally together for that individual. Second, you care by wanting to do for others. It was you and your class who came up with the idea and put into practice the raising of items for the homeless and working with the organization known as the Midnight Run. Third, you care for your peers in your school. It was you who last year changed how the senior dinner was to be done because you wanted them to know how much you appreciated them, to give them the very best, and in doing so, have now raised the standard for future years. The phoenix is one of my favorite mythical creatures because within it is seen the work of our Lord, who is the true first one. Our Lord did not lose to death, but overcame it by rising again, just as the phoenix rises from the ashes. But there are other attributes of the phoenix which I also see in you, and they are its fire, its tears, and its song. The fire of the phoenix is cleansing and warming. When you meet others who are cold within their hearts, share your warmth with them. The tears of the phoenix have healing properties. Share in the tears and sorrows of those whom you meet, and help them to be healed. And the song of the phoenix heartens and strengthens those who hear it. Go and inspires others to greatness with your words and with your actions. Although you think that I have taught you many things, what you don't realize is what you've taught me. Many people think that my life is a drudgery because they think I should be doing something quote-unquote greater. But nothing could be further from the truth. I actually look forward to being here, partly because I have no life. But in reality, it's because of all of you. I truly enjoy seeing and being with you. Most of the outside world thinks that because I don't have much material possessions, that I try to live a life of simplicity, that I don't have anything of value. But you have taught me otherwise. In the movie The Wizard of Oz, when the wizard gives the Tin Man his heart, he says to him, "Remember, a heart is not measured by how much you love, but by how much you are loved by others." And if that is true, then you have made me the richest man on the planet. Parents, thank you for the opportunity that you have given all of us in walking this journey with your children, for entrusting us with the great and awesome responsibility of preparing them for life. On the radio this morning, I learned that the year 2018 had been officially declared the year of the bird. How appropriate in this year that our own phoenixes head off into the world to change it. But remember the lesson taught in the story. As long as you keep your focus on the first one, you will rise from the ashes of your lives, namely the trials and sufferings that you may have to undergo. If you keep your focus on our Lord, who is the true first one, then you will overcome anything. Always remember that no matter where you go, that no matter what situation you are in, you are always a part of this family, and we are always here for you. Please come back and visit this old man once in a while, because he likes to see from time to time and to know how you are doing. And so, as you continue on your journey, never forget who you are and from whence you come. Go and set the world on fire with your light, and protect it from the enemy who seeks to destroy us. Go and let your light shine out into the world, because you make a bigger difference than you think. And so for one final time, let us all stand together. and praise. Heavenly Father, you sent your Son into the world in order to give us the example of how we are to live our lives as your sons and daughters. Send forth your Spirit upon these graduates, that they may take the knowledge and wisdom bestowed upon them and use it to sanctify the world as they journey through their lives. May the following words be inscribed in their hearts, so that they will always know how to live their lives in a holy and blessed way. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O Divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are all born to eternal life. Well, praise and bless my Lord, and give him thanks, and serve him with great humility. Amen.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
God bless you all. Thank you, Mr. Torelli. Please sit. Thank you, everyone, and God bless our graduates and you all. This concludes our ceremony. Have a wonderful summer, and we look forward to seeing you all next year at that first Thanksgiving break. Make sure you come visit us. Thank you.